Here are 6 free AI tools every entrepreneur needs to become a gazillionaire in 2025. How much is a gazillion? Let's just say Jeff Bezos would be jealous. A business exists to sell, but so many things behind the scene make that selling possible. If you don't at least do a decent job, your sales suffer. So like it or not, someone has to do it. The beauty of AI tools is that the amount of time spent doing these things goes way down. So, number one, Google NotebookLM for analyzing documents. Number two, Fathom for recording and summarizing meetings. Number three, Gamma for generating slide decks. Number four, Frase for copywriting. Number five, GmailPT for email management. And number six, Factors for lead generation. I think these tools address universally needed business functions. They all have a usable free plan. And yes, I mean free. None of that free after you key in your credit card details bullshit. One, Google NotebookLM. All of us at one point or another have tried to ask ChatGPT to analyze a document by copying and pasting into the chat box, only to be told it's too long. That's the core offering of Google NotebookLM. You can upload audio, PDF or HTML files into what are called notebooks. And each notebook can handle 25 million words across 50 sources. And you can ask the AI to analyze and combine information from your multiple sources. Here's my scriptwriter testing it out. He's uploading a blog we wrote comparing starter plans of different no-code app builders. Check out the video on that if you haven't. He then uploads an app brief we did for an upcoming client in the trucking and logistic industries. And here, he asks the AI to recommend the best no-code app builder to build the app in the brief. The answer is given in typical AI format, but instead of pulling information from who knows where, it's purely based on the sources provided. Instead of app briefs and no-code app builders, you could give the AI information about your pricing compared to other competitors. You could give the AI information about your past 6 months of cash flow or top performing products, pieces of business data that you want insight from. And here's a real minimum lovable product feature. You can turn a notebook into a podcast. It creates two hosts who will go back and forth over the content of your sources, and you can specify which one you want them to focus on. I listened to the podcast of my app brief and no-code app builders, and it was pretty cool. Link to it in the description if you are interested to hear it out. I get that the two hosts bantering things isn't to everyone's taste, but for digesting concepts and ideas, or to get a quick refresher, turning your notes into a podcast is a pretty sweet option to have. And I can totally see it being used to create audiobooks for employee manuals. But at its core, Google NotebookLM is an amazing tool for doing research. If you are already using ChatGPT to do research and you often need to combine various resources, there's no reason why you wouldn't use NotebookLM. Number two, Fathom. Have you experienced just finish a meeting and thinking, what did we talk about again? You can ask the group chat for the first time around, but how many times can you get away with it? Fathom is a free AI tool that records, transcribes, and summarizes your online meeting. After each meeting, it delivers this summary in an extremely easy to understand format right to your inbox. It shares the most pressing action item, key topics covered, who's doing what, and ends with a link to the full recording. The email you're seeing here is a recap of a meeting Ashraf didn't attend. So instead of sending him the entire meeting just like that, I sent him this Fathom recap so he can easily know what his next steps are. Because there is a summary, people are less likely to watch the full recording. But Fathom tries to address that by making the action items at the start function as timestamps, so you click on them and jump straight to the part of the recording where it's discussed. Whether it's internal or external, business meetings are a necessary evil. But you know what's a necessary evil? Post-meeting meetings. With a note-taking tool like Fathom with an always free tier, you can maximize your takeaways and be crystal clear on what you and everyone else need to do. And speaking of external meetings, next tool is a lifesaver. Number three, Gamma. I'm blessed to work with a team of talented designers who eat, live, and breathe design. So when it comes to making slide decks for clients, I'm covered. But not everyone is so lucky. And if you run a business where you need to pitch to clients or present reports to them, someone needs to make those PowerPoint slides. And it's for clients, so they can't just work, they gotta look nice. If I had to make my own slide decks for clients, I would just use Gamma. It's a free AI tool that can generate great-looking PDFs and slide decks tailored to your business design assets. You just need to create a custom theme by uploading an existing presentation with your logo, color, and font. When we did it, the only thing a bit off was it auto-detected the wrong color, which is an easy enough fix. Now, we tested out by asking it to create a slide deck of an app product roadmap based on a document I prepared. It's got all the information, but you know how clients are. When it comes to reading serious stuff, adults need children's book with pictures. Look at that! I think my designers could do a better job, but I also think their time could be better spent. If you are an entrepreneur who is cursed with shit design skills, Gamma was made for you. I accidentally found this out, and it seems kind of obvious now I think about it. But you can even ask the AI to translate documents you upload and create a slide deck or PDF in another language. My team and I at Upstack Studio help non-technical entrepreneurs grow past $5 to $10 million in annual revenue with custom software. We've worked with over 30 leading brands across industries. These businesses were stuck where no ready-made solution on the market solved their problem. To continue growing, they had to make their own solution. If your business is also currently stuck at this $5 to $10 million level and you want to explore custom solutions, let me help. There's a link in the description to sign up for a free, no strings attached strategy session. We'll dissect your current constraint together and you get an honest opinion about whether custom software is your answer. And if yes, we decide if we can work together. If it's not, you just save yourself from a very big investment with no ROI. Apply through the link and we'll be in touch. I'm only taking 3 of these calls per month and it's first come, first serve. So if you want to work with me, apply now. Back to the video. Number 4, Frase. I know that almost everyone uses AI as part of their blog writing nowadays, but many are still using ChatGPT, which is the equivalent of walking around with a Nokia brick phone. It works, but dude, it's 2025. Just like NotebookLM is a much better research assistant, a copywriting tool is a much better writing assistant than ChatGPT, especially when it's free. Case in point, Frase. Frase will search Google for your focus keyword and show you the HTML outline of the top ranking pages. You can then ask it to generate an outline and copy. It will also show you the classic keyword counter. You probably know by now keyword density doesn't matter, but I'll use it to measure my topic coverage. Am I producing overall guides? Then you'll want broad keyword coverage, a little bit of everything. Or am I narrowing down? Then I want to nail every keyword in my subtopic. And having all the keywords shown to you can be a huge help. And to me, the real value is in reviewing existing blogs. My app development cost breakdown blog is one of the top performers. So I want to make sure it does even better. See how many keywords I didn't even realize I was missing out on? ChatGPT wouldn't be able to help with that. The one catch is that Frase only lets you do 2 AI super optimized articles like this, but you can create an unlimited number of regular articles with AI prompts. If you upgrade to a paid plan, you get unlimited AI optimized articles and can directly integrate it with WordPress, so you write here and publish to your site without manual copy pasting. I still don't know why my banana curves sideways though. Might need to see a doctor. Number 5, GmailPT. Email is also a huge time and resource drain for the typical business owner. I'm not talking about email marketing. To me, that's marketing. I mean email. Reading and replying to team members and clients can take up an inordinate amount of time. So let's ordinate the shit out of it. At a certain level, it's why business owners hire professional assistants. But you're not at that level. You're broke. Doesn't mean you can't afford help when GmailPT is free. It's an extension for Chrome and Edge. You just need to install it and then whatever email you're reading, if it's too long or you don't have the time to reply, just highlight the text and click on GmailPT icon. A pop-up opens and you can ask the AI to explain it, summarize it, and draft a reply. Here's Ashraf using it to draft a reply to an interviewer. Is he hinting at me that he's quitting? Well, he can't quit if he's fired. So long, Ashraf. You get to choose a variety of reply tones, but I would just stick to formal. This is for work. You're not going to use AI to tell your mom you love her in an email. The whole point is for AI to handle the work stuff so you have time to tell her I love you in person and secure your inheritance. Number 6, Factors. I believe it's almost always better to sell a perfect solution to a group than a good enough solution to many groups. If you agree with me, we'll also agree product market fit is everything. Without that, you're selling a perfect solution to no group. We all start with a specific group of buyers, then monitor and see if it's resonating. That's a lot easier said than done. Factors makes it a bit easier to do that by helping you identify anonymous B2B traffic to your site, how they got there and what did they do. It does a bunch of other fancy mumbo jumbo with LinkedIn ads, but for me, that's something a technical marketer might be more interested in. For most business owners who just want to know who's visiting their site, Factor's free plan allows you to identify up to 200 companies visiting your site every month. So if you start to notice a lot of unrelated traffic, you can decide to whether change the product, change the site content or your ad targeting, or just roll with it and double down on the unexpected buyers. The point is, you'll know. Link to tools in the description. You can check them out yourself right now. Just know that no AI tool will print money for you while you sleep. You still need to put in effort, but if you're a real business owner, not just all talk, then AI will multiply your efforts and take away all distractions. You can save your time and manual work for the tasks that truly matter, whatever it may be. And if you're interested in creating an AI tool to sell, check out my video where I cover 3 amazing examples of AI integrations done right. This is how you do it. None of that junk ChatGPT wrapper shit. Also, if you found this video useful, please leave a like and subscribe. And I would love to hear about the free AI tools that you're using right now. Bonus points if you build it yourself. Cheers guys, thanks for watching.